Hello friends, as you know, we are moving ahead in the digital marketing season 2 with the new topic, how to know what's working and what is not. So this is a very few topics are remaining in this session. So don't forget to subscribe the online channel and hit the like button. I am your teacher Ankit in Nano Creation Digital Marketing season 2. Let's get started. Welcome back friends. As you all know, our latest topic is very interesting as how to know what's working and what is not in the digital marketing season 2 session. So hi there, you have got some online advertising campaigns up and running and you want to find out how they are doing. In this video, we will explain how to do just that by tracking conversions. We will cover what they are, how to choose the ones you want to measure and what technology to use to track them. One of the best things about SEM is that you can measure the value you are getting from your campaigns. This is very necessary for you. To do this, you track conversation, the key action you want website visitors to take using tools that search engines like Google or Bing provide. We will get to those in just a minute. Let's start with you how to choose with conversions to track. Say you are a nature photographer who sells prints online. What kinds of actions might count as conversions on your website? Obviously, placing an order is an important one, which is a normal tool. But what else might you want people to do? Well, your website should have a contact form so potential customer can ask your questions like what other prints you have for sale or if you are available to photograph special events. When someone submits an inquiry through this form, that's a conversion too. What if you don't sell prints online? Instead, you are a candid photographer and the bulk of your site is a portfolio of your work as well. You might have references in a downloadable PDF form, so when people download it, you can track that as a conversion. You could also have a link that people can click to receive your rates via email. That's another way potential customers can become paying customers, so you should track that as a conversion as well. In these two examples, we have mentioned a handful of different conversions, successful transactions, contact form, submissions and downloads, and there are plenty of other possibilities are still available. Can you think of what conversions you did want to track for your own business? So, how can you actually track these conversions? Well, you can use tools provided by search engines. These allow you or whoever is managing your website for you to place a small piece of code on certain pages of your website. That sounds complicated, especially if you don't have any technical support, but don't worry, we will walk you through it. Let's go back to the nature photography business, which is yours. You want to track a completed order, so you need to figure out the proper place of conversions tracking code. You wouldn't want to put the code on your homepage. If you do that, you will be counting conversions every time someone visits your site. Instead, you would install the conversion tracking code on the order confirmation page. That's the page customers see after they complete an order for you. That way, you know a conversion happened. Next, you decide to track online inquiries. Just like the previous example, you need to install the conversion tracking code on a page the visitor sees only after they submit an inquiry. For example, on the page that thanks the customer after they have placed an order. Make sense? In order to properly track conversions, you need to attach the code to pages someone will only see after they have taken the actions you want. Once you install the code, you will start getting reports that tell you how many conversions you have got. That's a valuable information in figuring out If your online ad campaigns are working, to sum up, by using online tools from search engines like Bing or Google, you can measure online conversions and set yourself up for success. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the like button. Thank you very much. Have a good day.